And we got a test run this week of what's to come next week. So the second to last week of July, that's what we just lived through. And it was good Thursday. We had the storms, but we didn't get in the 90s. Every other day we did. And every day next week, we're expecting high temperatures to be in the mid to low 90s. 95 seems to be a common theme. We will be above that tomorrow. We had one little thunderstorm tonight down in the Sand Hills. That is now history. And this is what the radar will look close to this weekend. Our rain chances are only 20 tomorrow and 10% on Sunday. So here's what your Saturday looks like. If you're up, madam, early for practice or chores or errands, mid-70s and we're dry. We jump quickly up to 82 at 9, 90 at noon with a high of 96 degrees. So more heat tomorrow, but not as much rain. Our chances are only 10 and 20% late afternoon and early evening. One solution to beat this heat is to head to the mountains. That's what Scott did earlier this month. He was up in Avery County, Banner Elk. It's in the far northwest corner of our state, and I guarantee it's not going to be 96 up there tomorrow. Beautiful super sunset. And do you see the little hidden surprise here on this? I'll give you a second. It's here in the top left corner. There's a little sliver of the moon sneaking through as well. Scott, one of the great photographers we have here in Central North Carolina, always has some amazing shots for us. I'll put this one, like I do every night, on my Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook page. I'm at WeatherWest if you want to take a second look. All right, so the pattern is unfortunately pretty simple. High pressure and hot temperatures at all levels of the atmosphere kind of dominating most of the country this weekend and early next week. So not only hot temperatures, high humidity, not a whole lot of rain as high pressure kind of is in control, and we'll have a decent amount of sunshine. So keep that in mind as we look at what's coming our way with temperature and heat index. So I mentioned it'll be a degree hotter tomorrow. The heat index will get as high as 105, very similar on Sunday, and even heading back to work on Monday, 94, and the thermometer is going to feel like 102. While these numbers are very hot and dangerous, there probably won't be a heat advisory on a technicality. We're just below those levels, so you may not see the headlines of heat advisory, but just know that it's dangerous heat. And know that you're going to struggle to find good rain chances this weekend. I know we never like our weekends to rain out, but we need some rain. And it'll help cool us off. Just not really in the cards for everybody this weekend. So Futurecast will take us through lunchtime tomorrow, keeping us dry. But we get into the afternoon, the peak heating. A few showers and thunderstorms are going to bubble up. Again, it's a 20% chance tomorrow. Here we are at 6 o'clock, kind of the same deal. Very widely scattered, so not for everyone. And then as we get into the evening, we dry out. Sunday, lower chance of rain. The morning starts off dry Sunday. And then we get into the afternoon. Again, you got to look hard for them, but there'll be a couple small, heavy downpours, maybe an isolated thunderstorm. So that's your weekend in a nutshell. Not a lot of rain, but a lot of heat. Similar conditions on Monday. Our best rain chances next week still look to be Tuesday and Wednesday, Thursday 30 and 40% chance, excuse me. And then your exclusive 10-day forecast. If you didn't get enough 90s this weekend or early next week, we've got more coming late next week. Angela, another 30, 40, and 30% chance of rain next Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. And a week from Monday is already August, and August is right before September. September is just before October when it'll probably finally cool down.
Yeah, and the leaves will start falling, and you know, then we'll just repeat this pattern again. All right, Wes, thank you.